Now, last thing that we want to look at before we finish up is considering rates of reaction. So rates of reaction are the rate at which a reaction occurs in terms of either minutes or something per minute or something per second. And it's ultimately going to be underpinned by thermodynamics. And so the reaction conditions refer to the environmental conditions and the lab conditions that affect reaction rate. So the main ones for these are temperature, pressure, and presence of catalysts. So temperature, when we consider temperature, higher temperatures may increase the reaction rate. And so this is because they will increase kinetic energy because we're putting more energy in as heat, and so there's more energy for these particles, so they're going to move around more. And so when the particles move around more, they're more likely to collide, to react, and then create a product. And so remembering they have to collide at the correct orientation at or above the activation energy in order to form products. So if there is this increase in kinetic energy and more collisions, it is more likely that the reactant particles will collide to then form products. With pressure, higher pressures can increase the reaction rate. And this is because at a higher pressure, there's a smaller area for the reactants to occupy. So if we're considering a gas, we've compressed the gas down into a smaller volume. So this is also associates with volume. So smaller volume will increase reaction rate. And so that's because we've compressed it down into a smaller area. So the molecules are moving around and they're going to be have a smaller space to move around. So they're more likely to collide to form products. And they're also more likely to collide at or above the activation energy because higher pressure equals higher temperature. And so there'll be greater kinetic energy. There's also more rebound off the sides of the container which it's inside. And so that means that there's more kinetic energy from that. And so they're more likely to collide at or above that activation energy and at that correct orientation to form products. And finally, we have catalysts. And so catalysts will increase the reaction rate because catalysts can either work by lowering the activation energy for the reaction. So this will mean that if the activation energy is lower, less energy is required when those molecules collide in order for a product to be produced. It can also hold the reactants in the correct orientation so that they will collide at their active sites, resulting in a functional product being produced. And that's because the molecules can collide at the correct activation energy at or above that activation energy and still not form products if they haven't collided on the right orientation. So having a catalyst which holds it in the right orientation ensures that when they do collide at that activation energy, they will definitely go on to form a product. And so when considering temperature and pressure, we can consider that all reactions can either be exothermic, so releasing heat energy, or endothermic, and so that would be taking in heat energy. And so some reactions may do work on the environment by producing more moles of gas by expansion. And so we can write the heat energy or work as pressure or as a product or as a reactant. And so we can see, for example, here with these here, we have delta H, which is our value. And so a negative delta H value is going to mean an exothermic reaction. And so that means heat is being produced, and so we consider heat like a product. Whereas we can have an endothermic reaction, and so an endothermic reaction will have a positive delta H value. And so that means that we are absorbing heat for the reaction to occur, so we're using heat in order for the reaction to occur. And so we're considering heat to be like a reactant. We also want to consider activation energy and our catalysts. So all reactions have an activation energy, regardless of whether they are a spontaneous or a non-spontaneous reaction. And this activation energy has to be overcome for the reaction to occur. And so often a lot of reactions occur at a very, very slow rate because it's very unlikely that the activation energy is reached by any of the molecules. But catalysts can be used to speed up this rate of reaction by binding to the reactants and facilitating the formation of products. Because they don't participate in the reaction, but they provide an alternative reaction pathway by lowering the activation energy so that it's easier for the activation energy to be reached, or holding it in the right direction so that the active sites can be collided. And so we can see on the left here, we have a non-spontaneous endothermic reaction. And we can see we have this rate of reaction. We have less energy in the reactants, more energy in the products. And then with an exothermic reaction, we have more energy in the reactants, less energy in the products, showing that energy is being released.